I want to talk more about the treasuries, because this is a little vague in my mind, but I've when I was doing some research, some really good questions surfaced. So in a DAO's treasury, how is it structured? Who manages it? And how do you account for volatility?
So how is it structured? Right now, basically, the smart contract that represents the governance owns the token. So it has an address, and that's the address that owns the token. And so that means that basically that smart contract can decide what it wants to do with the token and send them away. To decide, the smart contract has, I mean, it's through governance, right? So basically you can execute, say, hey, the contract will send 5 tokens there, 10 tokens there, or 100 here. So that was the first one. Like, how is it structured? Well, right now the contract has 2 types of tokens, if I'm correct. The UDT, so some of the governance tokens that we've allocated to it. And again, through governance, and it's just through governance, nobody else can do anything about these tokens, but the collective of people that own some other governance token can decide what to do with them. It can be burn them, it can be send them to an address, it can be sit on them and don't not do anything with them. So that's one thing. How is it? And the other type of token that the contract has is they're called liquidity provider token, LP tokens.
Okay.
Because for complex reason that maybe we don't need to go into here, because that's not really relevant for the governance discussion, but like Unlock Inc. had to create a liquidity pool on Uniswap to set a price for these tokens, because the number of tokens minted when the protocol is used is based on its price. When you do that on Uniswap, you earn liquidity LP tokens. We decided that we're not going to take these tokens for ourselves. We give them to the DAO as a way to say, hey, this is another thing that the DAO can use and leverage for this. So right now, the treasury is just 2 things. It's some UDT and then some of Uniswap LP tokens. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Now, who manages this? Well, the DAO, basically. Collectively, we're going to have to decide what we want to do with these tokens. And again, it can be we do nothing. We burn them. We swap some for some others, so we can say, hey, we're going to sell some UDT for DAI, which is a dollar stablecoin. Or even better, we can even do partnership with other DAOs and say, hey, we're going to give you some of our token and you're going to give us some of yours as a way to make sure that we keep our interests aligned in some way. So that would be the kind of thing that we can do with these tokens.
Okay. So let's say that I approach a nonprofit reaches out and they want to set up a DAO.
Yep.
In order for them to manage the treasury, let's say they hire somebody to put the smart contracts in place and set up all of their governance and all that.
Yep.
Do they need to have somebody on staff that can then understand how all of this works? Or will the contract just basically execute based on how they've set it up, regardless of whoever touches it?
Exactly. The contract, that's the point, right? It's like autonomous in the sense that it executes as it is written, and nobody needs to be doing special things to execute it. Like, you don't need a manager to say, hey, cool, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. So once it's deployed, it's there and it behaves as it was designed to behave.
Okay. So that is one of the things I've been trying to wrap my head around. Like, when I look at a nonprofit that I want to help, I'm like, I can't imagine anybody internally being able to, barely manage our email. How in the world would you manage the structure of a DAO?
I mean, so, email is a good thing, right? Like, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, I actually applied for jobs at and where I know that the people that I was applying for basically asked somebody else to print their emails and then manage the emails on their behalf. We're definitely away from that world. Like, everybody now does their own emails. I think it's the same for these governance things. Like, at some point, it's going to become an obvious thing. Like, oh, I'm there. I have these votes. I'm going to vote on this. I'm going to do this. There's going to be nice UIs to submit proposals. It's like, oh, I want the DAO to do XYZ. So it's going to be kind of a little form that I say, hey, I want the DAO to send a number of these tokens to that other address. Feels like this is the kind of thing that we're going to have. And these nonprofits will definitely be able to use that in that world. What they have to do, though, is if they want to manage a treasury or funds, they would have first to take their dollars on their bank account and actually put them on chain, because that's the only thing that the DAO can manage. The DAO cannot say, Chase account 123 will make a wire transfer to Chase account 456. The DAO cannot do that because this is off-chain. The DAO can only do on-chain things.